Hi, my name is Stefan Linzner, and I'm a developer advocate on the Android team here at Google. Today, I'm going to talk about a new testing API which we've introduced with Android 4.3, UiAutomation. UiAutomation is a new API that introduces full screen introspection support into the Android instrumentation framework. Why is this important? Because it enables testing across application boundaries within your instrumentation tests. But let's have a look at a quick example. Here are some screenshots of the new Google Maps app. Let's say we want to write a functional test for this scenario using the instrumentation framework. What we would do is to start the activity on the left, click on the navigation icon, wait for the dialog to appear, then click the Enable button. But as of now, there was no easy way to actually turn a GPS on. The problem is that the instrumentation framework is limited to tests within its target package only. With UiAutomation, this restriction no longer holds. And now we can test the complete user flow. Go to the settings screen, enable the GPS by checking the box, and press the back button. So let's have a quick look at the API supported by UiAutomation. UiAutomation enables full screen introspection support using the accessibility attributes. It allows for taking screenshots from right within your instrumentation tests, and I know this was a feature that was requested for a very long time. It also supports changing of the change of the device orientation and injection of raw input events. Maybe one more note here. UiAutomation is a very low-level API, but this was done on purpose to encourage development of UI testing tools such as UiAutomator, as well as to allow developers to use it in their instrumentation tests. And in fact, the UiAutomator framework, which we introduced with Jelly Bean 4.1, is built on top of the UiAutomation APIs. So let's have a look at some code. What do you have to do to get started with UiAutomation? It's very simple. You just have to inherit from instrumentation test case or from any other subclass like activity instrumentation test case 2. Then in your test method, just call getInstrumentation.get UiAutomation to get a reference to the UiAutomation object. The question is, how do you run these tests? It's not so different from what it was before. You just have to use the adb shell am instrument command with providing the -w option, your target package, and your test runner. So let me show you how you could introspect any visible screen content from within your instrumentation tests. First, we get a reference to the UiAutomation object. But as the window content is presented as a tree of accessibility nodes, in this case, we have to obtain the active window root accessibility node first. This is done by calling getRootInActivityWindow. From there, we can continue and query for any node by text or ID. But note, this search is always relative to the retrieved root accessibility node. Another cool feature which UiAutomation introduces is to capture screenshots using the instrumentation framework. In order to retrieve a bitmap of the current screen content, we have to call takeScreenshot, which returns a bitmap object, which then can be written to the file system. UiAutomation also allows for the injection of raw input events into the system. In order to inject an event, you have to call the injectInputEvent method. For example, if you want to inject a motion event, just obtain an event object from the pool and pass it as a parameter. But note that it's your responsibility to recycle the input event and return it to the pool. Furthermore, you can execute commands and listen for their corresponding accessibility events using an accessibility event filter. For example, we can pass a runnable as a parameter to execute and wait for event, which taps on the screen, and then verify this tab by listening for the corresponding accessibility event. But what you also can do is listen for all accessibility events in the event stream. This is also very easy by just passing an instance of onAccessibilityEventListener to the setOnAccessibilityEventListener method. Your listener interface then receives a callback each time an accessibility event occurs. Thank you very much for listening and happy testing.